What a mess. Those directions were so unhelpful. Doesn't Jesse know I'm not from around here? Oh, hey, I'm so glad you're here. Maybe you can help me. Remember how we spent a few lessons learning about the Northeast region of the United States? Well, I thought it would be a great idea to go on a road trip starting here before making our way over to our next region for Operation Exploration. The problem is, I just had a terrible time navigating my way to my first landmark. It all started when I was driving along the highway in Maine, checking out the rocky coastline, when I decided to stop and call my friend Jesse for some directions. I wanted to visit the Stellafane Observatory in Vermont.
Oh yeah, the Stellafane Observatory. That's easy. Just head west. It's south of Spoonerville.
I had no idea what to do. I don't even know where Spoonerville is. I spent a long time trying to navigate around, and I had to ask more people for help to find my way. Luckily, I eventually made it here, but can you see the problem with the directions Jesse gave me? Describing locations is what we'll be learning about today, so we can avoid another situation like that. By the end of today's video, you will be able to define absolute and relative location, and give directions using an absolute or relative location. Let's get into it. Let's backtrack to what we've learned so far about maps and locations. Remember these? These are lines of latitude and longitude. These lines are important for being able to pinpoint precise locations on Earth. We call this an absolute location. An absolute location describes a specific spot on Earth. But most people don't use lines of latitude and longitude in their daily lives. Most people would have no idea what you were talking about if you suddenly started spinning out coordinates at them. Instead, we use things like street names and addresses. These are also absolute locations. So, yes, the Stellafane Observatory is at 43°.16′:42″ north, 72°.31′10″ west, but most people would probably tell you it's at 211 Jordan Road in Springfield, Vermont. Those are two ways to describe the absolute location of the observatory. That would have been helpful when I was trying to find it. Remember when Jesse was trying to tell me where the Stellafane Observatory was? He told me it was south of Spoonerville. Does that sound like an absolute location? What Jesse was giving me was a relative location. Relative location is a description of where a place is compared to somewhere else. So when might someone use a relative location? We can use relative location when the person we're talking to knows about the locations we're using to describe where something else is. Let's say we live in the same town that just got a new bank. We might use relative location to say to someone, oh, the new bank is down the road from the market. Anyone who knew where the market was would be able to find their way to the bank with this relative location. But if they didn't know where the market was, they'd feel like I did when I was looking for the observatory, lost and confused. But not to worry. Remember, I asked some local people to help me and made it to the Stellafane Observatory. Now, I'm gonna find some time to swing by Connecticut and Rhode Island for some lobster rolls, clam chowder, crab cakes. Anyway, I'll meet you at my next stop. Okay, now I'm here in New York City at my favorite pizza place, Joe's Pizza. I have an idea. let's practice using relative and absolute location together to continue the road trip from here. This is how I describe where I am right now to someone else. If the person was new to the city, I'd definitely want to give them the absolute location. I'd say, hey, check out Joe's Pizza at 7 Carmine Street, New York City, New York, 10014. But if someone was from the neighborhood, they'd probably know enough to understand relative location, even if they don't know where Joe's Pizza is itself. So I could tell them Joe's Pizza is a few blocks southwest of Washington Square Park, or across the street from Mineta Playground. See how I use the landmarks near Joe's Pizza to give a relative location? Okay, I'm gonna be starting the next part of the road trip here at Joe's Pizza. I want to go over to MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, and then to the Liberty Bell in Pennsylvania. Do you think you can help me navigate? First up, MetLife Stadium. I've been here a few times, so you can send me a text message to remind me of the relative location of the stadium. Pause the video here to write the text message on the phone image in your PDF. I made it! I would say MetLife Stadium is north of Secaucus or east of Rutherford. Next, I'll head over to the Liberty Bell. Since I'm not as familiar with that area, you should give me the absolute location. Pause the video here to write me a text with the absolute location on the phone image on your PDF. Wow! Thanks to those directions, I'm here! The Liberty Bell is located at 526 Market Street, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19106. That absolute location helped me know exactly where to go. Thanks so much for helping me navigate my way through the Northeast. Now you know that absolute location is a way to describe precise locations on Earth. We can describe absolute location using latitude and longitude, but we most often use street names and addresses. You also now know that relative location is a description of where a place is compared to somewhere else. We describe where things are using words like east or west or close to or near. It's time to move on to our next region for Operation Exploration. Have fun practicing more with location, and I'll see you in the South. Bye-bye.